29-year-old Amber Scott only eats French fries, devouring over 56 kilos of deep-fried French fries each and every month. Yearly, that's the equivalent of 6,000 potatoes, 115 potatoes every single week.
Amber eats French fries, breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
But Amber cannot just eat any French fries. Smell, color, and texture are also important.
A lot of the times fries will have a burnt end like this. That is definitely something that I cannot eat. So I will take that and pinch it off and stick it underneath the napkin and then eat the rest of the fry.
I will feel even a little euphoric after eating fries. I'm not sure what it is about them that makes them so good, but I like the way they make me feel.
Why do you think that you're only reaching for those French fries?
I feel that there is something beyond, oh, I don't want to eat that. I mean, that's definitely not it, because I do want to eat it. And there are foods that I have sat down and have tried.
What happens?
I throw it up.
Okay, so I'm hearing you do want to try to eat healthy.
Yes, I've tried.
But you can't.
I can't. I definitely am leaning more towards the fact that it's medical, because I know that what I'm doing is not a choice. I mean, even just one new food can open up a whole lot of options for me, even one.
Good.
So before Amber tackles a completely new taste, Dr. Dow starts with a familiar food that only looks a little different.
Start with tastes and also textures that you already like, and then we change one thing at a time. This is going to teach your brain that you can't eat this.
I am very nervous, and even though French fries are a safe food, changing their color makes me feel uneasy.
I would like for you to taste one of the red French fries.
I feel like this is not a baby step, and this is not where I would have chosen to start. I guess it's this one. I wanted it over with. I just wanted to be done with the rainbow fries.
How are you feeling right now?
I'm trying to figure out how I'm gonna do this.
Every time you try something new, you are going to be one step closer to having the life that you want.
Yuck.
There was a real yuck face when you put that in your mouth.
It wasn't pleasant.
But it also wasn't extremely unpleasant.
Right.
The fact that Amber was able to take a bite, to me, is a success. I just want Amber to have a bite, to have the experience, and to say, did I die? No, and if not, then I'm okay.
Building on her progress, Dr. Dow now moves on to an even more unnatural color, blue.
What are you feeling right now by looking at that blue fry?
It looks like a dead blue finger.
The average person may say, eating a blue French fry is no big deal. You know, why is she crying over this? But you have to understand that for Amber, emotionally, it's like jumping out of an airplane.
Here.
I want to give you a huge amount of credit for what you just did. I knew that any step that we take is going to provoke some fear in Amber. But the fact that she was able to take this step says that she can indeed make changes to her diet and her life. This was hard for you, and you did it.
After a day of intense therapy, Amber has made the first difficult step in treating her psychological fear of new foods. Now, Dr. Dow and JJ want to see if she can take an even bigger leap and try a new taste.
Amber is used to eating deep-fried potatoes every single day. I thought the easiest step for her to make was to stay within the deep-fried and then try new tastes in that fashion.
JJ orders a variety of different vegetables, ranging from the familiar, like potato, to the unfamiliar, such as carrots, asparagus, and mushroom.
All right, so where do you want to start? Shall we start easy?
All right.
Okay.
JJ wanted me to try deep frying the potato. It was apprehensive on so many levels.
What does it smell like?
It smells like a potato in canola oil. Now, whether it smells like a French fry.
But we have something in the ballpark of familiar, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, geez. See, I don't think this is food. I don't think it's anything, you know?
Logically, gonna kill you?
No, but I mean,
eating dirt won't kill me. It doesn't mean it's a good idea.
She uses so much all or nothing thinking. She uses a lot of catastrophic thinking. I want Amber to understand that there is some gray area here. Not everything has to be pleasant to her, but it doesn't have to be all bad.
But you could eat this and keep it in your mouth, right?
Probably.
Well, in that case, bon appetit.
That tasted like sod. Why are you looking at me that way? It did.
Amber's a tough case because Amber is only going to do what Amber wants to do.
All of us on carrots?
Sure.
Ready for carrots?
To keep moving forward, JJ suggests another mild tasting vegetable, a carrot.
Is that right? Is that how it's supposed to look?
I've never had a deep fried carrot before.
Try new things. And you're okay. So what did you teach yourself today, Amber?
I didn't teach myself anything. None of this came as a surprise.
You look really angry at us right now.
I'm angry because what do you want me to do right here? I'm trying, but when I keep getting pushed a little. I'm pushed to my limit for the day.
Then that's all you had to do.
Okay.
Did you get that you did exactly what you could do and that's all we expected of you?
Amber gets really flustered. That tells me that there's such a reaction in Amber with her emotions, that a lot of these things aren't going to click for her until maybe tomorrow, the day after. Our intention is not to get you mad. It is to help you to move forward.
I want to get the hell out of here. I am seriously pushed to my limit for today, guys. And I can't do it.